It's already been said, we're here to celebrate the life of Kathy. And for those of you I've not met, I'm Sharon, I'm Carrie's mom. And Kathy had asked Carrie a while back if she would do a reunion. And Carrie agreed. But then when it comes time, it's a little harder to do than she realizes. And so because of emotions and everything, she asked me to stand in her stead and to be her proxy. So the words that you're going to hear are Carrie's words, not mine, although I totally concur with every statement that's made here. So from Carrie. Sometimes the distance between what we think and what we say is insurmountable. And no matter how much we arrange and rearrange the words, they can never convey what we really feel inside. Each person present today knows the effect that Kathy had on you in life as well as in her passing. Those impressions are too delicate to be substantiated in words, but with your patience, I'm going to try. I don't want to make this a tribute about the battles she fought with cancer. I would rather remember the woman she was and the lives she touched. But I do want to say a few things about that battle through this phase of her life. Kathy fought cancer with every ounce of her being for 6 years. She had a great support team and prayer warriors by her side. When we moved to Gadsden for better health care, the treatments and surgeries she received at UAB were amazing. God healed Kathy. God healed Kathy. Hear those words. For 2 years. God gave Kathy the opportunity to give back to others. I want to go back to God healed Kathy. Because even though it was through UAB and surgeries and everything, she would not have gotten that in Florida. They'd given her 6 months to live. But she did, through the different surgeries, that there was a healing. There was a miracle that took place for 2 years. It was obvious. God gave Kathy the opportunity to give back to others, to share her love for God to many people at the Way of the Cross where she volunteered. God gave her the opportunity to right some wrongs. That would be nice for all of us. God gave her the opportunity to live, to really live. And we all know she took advantage of every day she had. Kathy would want me to say thank you. Thank you to everyone for your constant prayers, for the visits and phone calls. She would want me to say thank you, Trudy, for being a wonderful friend and for all the pick-me-ups and that you sent and the constant words of encouragement you gave her. She felt fortunate to have such a true friend. Kathy would want me to say thank you to the ladies of the cross, to the Way of the Cross, and Brother Brown for welcoming her into your family. She appreciated being able to share her love for people and for God to these people. And she loved the Way of the Cross, as well as all those people there. It was a place of service and acceptance for Kathy. And as for service, Kathy also loved the church. It was there a couple of years ago that she was baptized and began her life of service. Working on serve days, she threw herself wholeheartedly into the day. Then it was with the church that she was able to provide disaster relief on a mission trip. Service was who Kathy. Dustin, Amanda, Maylee, Jr. She was happy, so happy you guys came to Alabama to spend time with her and to be her caregivers. There are only so many words to describe how thankful she was for all of you and for Ryan and Savannah. The group effort you guys put into taking care of her every need was amazing. She knew, and this is, okay, let's take this with, stop it, this is Kathy. She knew she wasn't easy to please, and you can all laugh there. She also appreciated your attempts to cook for her. So, on a serious note, she loved you and take this for what I'm saying. She loved you more than life. All of you. She loved you more than life. Her kids. Courtney, where are you, baby? She was grateful for the many trips you made to be with her and help her in her care. She so enjoyed her time with you. And as we've discussed, you guys share wonderful weirdness. And she said, Gary said, I hope you never lose that because you're Kathy made over, her clone for sure. Okay, so enough about cancer. Let's talk about Kathy. Kathy was born on December the 23rd, 1967. She almost had another birthday. Mary and Rudy Robinson raised Kathy, her three brothers, George, Buster, Kenny, and Chris. They lost Kenny in 2010. She lost her dad, Rudy, in 2015. Kathy was a daddy's girl, and during his final days, she would not leave his side. Kathy had three children, Tiffany, married Bruce Douglas, Courtney Robinson, and Dustin, and Amanda Skelton. She had three grandchildren that changed her life, and she adored them, Aiden, Douglas, Maley, and Dustin, which we call Junior. He's Junior. We've got a Dustin, don't we? Junior. Okay, Skelton. Kathy was determined in every aspect of her life. And we've said several different words. Determined. Kathy was determined. She was determined to be the best at anything and everything she did. Every company that she worked for, she dug in and learned everything she could to advance to the top of her career. Kathy excelled in every company in which she worked. Her final career at Gold Mine in Hickson, Tennessee was in outside sales. She worked very hard to become the outside sales rep, the top, the best. She was. She succeeded. Okay, we talked about several things Kathy was. And you already know this from what Trudy said. She was adventurous. She trained for and eventually hiked a portion of the Appalachian Trail. She met lots of new people and shared her love for God, life, and nature. Kathy was happiest anywhere in nature. She wouldn't think twice about packing up and camping or kayaking alone. She found great peace in being in God's creation. Her adventurous nature took her to many places, and fortunately, she brought me along for many of those, which brings me to another word to describe Kathy, daredevil. While visiting Cozumel, we took a dune buggy adventure. I took the first turn and drove up to a beautiful waterfall. Of course, I was stuck behind the slowest driver in the group, and we were not allowed to pass. So, when we get to the waterfall, many people wanted to jump from the high cliff. Guess who was the first to jump? Yeah. On the way back, it was Kathy's turn to drive. Obviously, she took off first and flew through every mud hole and small jump she came across. Close to the end of the trail, there was a huge jump that would land us in the biggest mudhole. I was begging Kathy to not hit it at full speed because I had my contacts in and I didn't bring an extra pair. But she at first said, oh, okay. And the closer we got, she looked over at me and said, hold on. I was still begging, please, no. She looked back with her mischievous look and floored it. I think we were in midair for at least 5 seconds. And when we hit the mudhole, it was at full speed. There was not a part of our bodies that wasn't covered in mud. Obviously, I couldn't see, but I saw enough and heard her beautiful laughter and knew she was having the time of her life. It was a lot of fun, even though I tried to be mad. We did have a blast. In Key West, we rented a moped. My driving was too slow and cautious for Kathy. So she took the driver's seat and we saw Key West, or actually we flew through Key West. These are just a couple of examples of many places and adventures Kathy took me on and forced me out of my comfort zone. But she taught me how to have fun. She loved adventure and traveling. She was never afraid to do anything, whether it was ziplining, four-wheeling, spending the day driving through the long country roads in the convertible. Everything was an adventure for Kathy. She was easy to be around. No matter what social group Kathy was in, she felt at home and mixed well with any group. She never met a stranger and loved all people and made sure they knew it. Every time she got home from Walmart, which was usually a two-hour trip, she would have the greatest stories from the people she had met and talked with. Kathy was honest. You said that. Kathy was honest. Everyone knew you didn't ask Kathy unless you wanted to know the truth. So many times I asked her for the truth, hoping she would sugarcoat it just a little bit. But no, not Kathy. She told it just like she saw it. One of the many things I admired about her. Do I even need to say this? Kathy was loving. She loved her family more than anything. And wanted so much. Where are you, grandkids? She wanted so much to leave a legacy for you guys. For kids and grandkids. And I believe she did exactly that. She showed us all that God still heals. He healed her for a season in life, and now she is completely healed in heaven. Kathy knew she had made mistakes in life, so she showed us how for all of us to accept responsibility for our mistakes and work through our problems. She showed us all what a fighter looks like. She fought for life because of you and me, each of us. She so wanted to see you guys grow up. And to adults. So Aiden, Maley, Junior, Momo is in heaven, cheering you on. She is your biggest fan. So I want you, Carrie wants you, Momo would want you to honor her life by looking for that life in Christ that she had and live your life to the fullest the way Momo did. I have something that Kathy wrote through her journey with cancer. And I'm going to share that right now. This is Kathy's words. And there, to get through this one. It's been 3 years since my original cancer diagnosis. 2 years since my then oncologist sat across from me, advised me the cancer had spread, held my hand and said, without chemo, you have 6 months to live. But with chemo, you might be lucky to get 2 years. So here I am at the anniversary of my predicted death and feeling well. In your face, cancer. Well, will cancer have the last laugh eventually? Who knows? I can only say for certain, each day is a gift. I'm enjoying every laugh, hug, smile, and moment through life. This journey of light and dark days, a life touched with cancer, has brought me far more than it has taken. Cancer has taken all my finances, actually obliterated them. But what it has given me in return is freedom from the material things in life. It took some friends. Yes, you lose friends. I can only assume it is because they didn't know what to say and it was easier for them this way, but in return, it brought me new friends who are holding my hands in prayer and won't turn away during the dark days. It has taken my eyesight, but in return, opened my eyes wider to see all the beauty around me and the beauty in each and every person. It has taken a lot of my energy and stamina, which requires me to stop more frequently or break. But in return, I now have the ability to stop and smell roses. It has taken my memory, but in return, given me the ability to
to make memories for others. It has taken my selfishness, but in return, given me the ability to unselfishly give of myself and my time to others. It has taken hundreds of miles and placed in between me and my family because of my treatment, but in return has given me more visits with quality time that I would have taken for granted before. The list of cancer taketh, but giveth in return is long. So I will leave you with one last thought. We were all given the inept ability to choose how to handle crisis in our lives. You choose to be an ugly person or a beautiful person on the inside. You choose to be resentful or grateful. You choose to have a good day or a bad day. And when life knocks you down, roll over and admire the stars. I am, and I hope you will too. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to make you cry. But the song that we're going to do right now was written by Vince Gill, and it was written when his brother died. So it's spoken, it's sung to a man. So please hear in this, Kathy, please just hear the words to be her and my daughter.